You got like a Christmas red sweater on.
I got a little. Yeah, I'm in the holiday spirit right now.
Hey, congratulations. You just announced that you're going to have a baby.
I did. Yes, yes. Thank you. Thank you so much. Just announced it. Yes.
She's going to have a sister.
She's going to have a sister. She's going to have, yes, a little sister. That's our baby, Jasmine Leah, and just made the announcement today. And Lauren and I are so happy. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
That's great.
You know, and the crazy thing is I was raised by women, and I still to this day totally and completely 100% surrounded by only women.
Well,
yes. And I love it.
Yeah. That's actually a good thing.
It is a wonderful thing.
That's a really good thing.
Yes.
We've dropped the rock for a while now, right? You're not the rock anymore. There's no more rock.
Well, you know, in many hearts, there's always the rock.
Yes.
During the holiday season, a character by the name of Dwanta Claus takes over and becomes becomes a new identity.
I see.
Yes.
So you're Dwanta Claus, because Dwanta Claus does a lot of really good things.
Yeah. Thank you. Yes. Dwanta Claus does a lot of good things, a lot of nice things. You know, he's all ages, all races, non-denominational. He is very nice and a lot naughty, and so he welcomes naughty too as well.
Yeah. I see.
It's a good audience.
Uh-huh. And he makes special appearances on sets.
He does. You know, what we have started doing now is for my movie sets, I love the idea of turning my movie sets into like what I describe as like Willy Wonka's chocolate factory, where there's just, and for kids. So I do a lot of, for Make-A-Wish and for kids who, and families who are struck. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. It's really, and I know you feel the same way. It's like the best parts of our job. So I do a lot with Make-A-Wish and for kids who are in hospice, and we fly them up to or whatever set that I'm at, and we just make sure that they have the greatest time. You know, we have Xbox will be there. They'll set up a kiosk where they're all playing Xbox, or Lamborghini will come in and deliver cars for them to ride in, and the crew is always so happy to make the kids' day. Every director will have every kid come up and yell, action, and yell cut, and then I'll make sure that they come up and give me direction. Like I say, I refuse to talk to the director. The kids must give me direction.
Oh,
they come up and give me direction.
That's really sweet.
It's really cool.
It's really, you know, for what a great guy you are, what a good guy you are, and you're having so many good things happening for you and to you, for you to lose the title of sexiest man, this must have been a tough thing.
Oh, man.
How are you taking it? Because...
Well, to be honest with you, you know, Ellen, it's not easy.
No.
It's not easy, but I'll also be honest with you about this, and I'll be honest with the audience here, is the truth is, now I love Blake and I love his music, right? And but the truth is, I will never give up the title of Sexiest Man Alive. I literally refuse to give it up.
Good. Well, you can still fight to win it back. In your heart and in a lot of people's heart, you still are, but you're going to have to fight. Maybe you just didn't work hard enough this year at the sexiness.
That was it. I thought I did. Yeah. But he came in the 11th hour.
Yeah.
And just beat
under
me
the radar.
Right under the radar.
That was a surprise to everybody.
I didn't expect that.
Yeah.
But yes.
Nobody did.
I thought I was going to be two-time back-to-back.
Yeah. And then here he comes. All right. We're going to take a break. Yeah. Look at that guy.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway. So.
You can arm wrestle him.
No.
All right, we're going to take a break. You brought a friend with you, and we'll bring him out after this.
It was so much louder.
Wow.
Yeah, stop it. That's what it feels like, buddy.
Oh, you okay? God, you were pretty bored out here by yourself with this guy. I couldn't wait to come save you. I said, I gotta go save my Ellen.
Hey, Merry Christmas, Ellen. Look at me.
Merry Christmas.
Look at me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
kind of thing.
I know, yeah. No, well, we go way back.
No, this is my good friend.
Yeah, I know.
This is my good friend.
Well, I go to her Christmas party, so
you know. We had a talk about you coming on. I almost shut it down. I came close to shutting it down. I didn't because you're my friend, but just know it could have happened.
Well.
She asked me, Kevin, are you okay with this? I said, well, it depends. How do you feel? We had a little back and forth about your attitude. We'll talk about it later.
Let's talk about it later.
You were supposed to be here a few weeks ago, and then your wife went into labor, and you have a brand new little baby.
Yeah. It was tough. I had to choose. Look at me, being a dad.
I had to choose, because she was, I think she was like 4 centimeters dilated. And I was like, it's the baby or Ellen, honey. Like, you got to, you know, I don't want to cancel.
If you liked her, I would have chosen Ellen.
It was a conversation.
I don't know.
No, but it was amazing, man. We were in the hospital for 24 hours. She was in labor for 24 hours. And I've realized that I'm helpless. Like, there's nothing you can really do. Even with your chairing, I got nothing to do with
that. But you're just there.
No, that's it. They were like, Kev, you want to come on this side? And I said, absolutely not. I don't want to go down there at all. So I just stayed up top, said push as loud as I could. There was a moment where she told me to shut up, and I was like, will do. And that was it. Then the baby came out. I cried instantly, man. It was an amazing feeling. My son, my daughter were excited about their little brother. It was honestly just the feeling of knowing that another little one is dependent on me is the best thing in the world. That's what I love.
Yeah.
Good man.
Congrats.
Thank you, brother.
Congrats, man.
Thank you.
Another girl.
Yes, another girl.
Yeah, he can't make boys.
Are you?
All that man.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Goodness gracious. Goodness.
Well, once Kevin finds out who the dad is for his boy, it's got to be good. Yes, keep talking. Yeah, go ahead. Shut it down. This is what happens when we get together.
That's pretty fast.
Yeah. That's quick.
Pretty fast.
Yeah. Hey, tell me what you think about, you know, I don't know if this is true, but people talk about you running for president. What do you think if you would run for president?
Sure. You know, I'll give a serious answer. I give you crap all the time.
Yes.
But, you know, this is daytime TV, so I'll keep my real opinion between us. You know what, man? I think the world that we're living in today, you're seeing the real effect that genuine people like Dwayne have. And the one thing about him is he's very serious when it comes to spreading that love, that laughter, and just the upselling of life on a positive level. And if he were to put himself in that position, he would get my support cold-heartedly. I mean, unless it comes to a financial dollar, then we gotta talk.
Yeah.
But I know where his heart is. I really know him. So I know if he puts himself in that position, it's for the better of the people. I can only applaud him and support him for doing that. I would
Thank
have
you,
to sit up and applaud the big guy.
Will you run?
Thank
I mean,
you.
Would you, seriously, would you run?
I'm seriously considering it, yes.
Well, you
really?
Can. He can't physically run. He can't run. His knees are bad.
No, I can
it's
run.
It's really
That's
bad knees.
Yeah, I don't run New York Marathon.
That'll be tough if the president ever had to run.
Like, don't say,
President, get away, go! He's not going to be able to do it.
He's not.
No, his knees
don't
are bad.
Don't encourage him, guys. That's
his knees are horrible.
All right. That's exciting. That's exciting news that you would run. I think.
Would you want me on your team? Would you want me to do something? There's a lot I can do. What would you want me
to
do?
There's a lot you shouldn't do.
But there's a lot.
Can you just imagine how if he was on my team? Should I do it now, DJ?
You want the button
right now?
I'll press the button right now.
No.
No. I'll do it right now.
No.
I'm sick and tired of everybody talking about us like this.
All right, we have to take a break. We'll be back. With Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart from Jumanji, welcome to the jungle.
My name first.
Well, it's only because of where you were, because you came out first. That's the only reason why. We don't have to get into this now.
She likes me more.
All right, so the movie is about high school characters that get sucked into this whole situation.
Yes.
And in high school, what were you like? I'll start with you, Dwayne.
Yeah, sure. Well, I struggled in high school because I was like a walking
walking.
Please,
just give it the real definition.
Okay, I will. Well, when I was was 14, 15, I was a walking contradiction because I was already probably 6'3", yeah. 180, yeah. maybe 200. I had a big mustache. Yeah. I looked like I was 48. Yeah. I was struggling. I was really struggling in high school. Yeah. That's me. That's me in high school.
Whoa.
But,
whoa.
But yes. Don't laugh like that. Don't.
Whoa.
That's okay. What? Well, there's my picture.
Whoa. No, wait. Well,
what just happened?
What do you, don't.
What?
Don't you laugh like that.
You look like a detective that's a DJ.
I'm trying. This is why I need therapy these days. I okay, you laugh. I actually bought a picture of Kevin for you guys when he was 16 as well.
So he, same age.
Same age. There he is. Yeah, look at you. Uh-huh. Ah, he's doing this. I wish I was this tall, but I'll never get this tall. No, I'm always going to be shorter than everybody's cat.
Yeah. I hate that I'm standing right next to the stove. That's what I hate. Like, there's no way for me to say I was a big child or nothing. Like, everything is right here.
It's the perspective.
No, it's really bad. This is really bad.
No taller than the stove at 16.
Well, as you can see, I was a cool kid, though.
He was cool in high school. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Always cool. You could tell. I never had a problem with being cool, you know?
Hey, so you two, you really are good together. I just said that during the break. I love you two together. What is it that that clicked right away when you met?
On a serious note, it's a mutual respect and admiration for two individuals that started the same. You know, we both come from nothing, and our road to getting something is a road that we don't take for granted. It's something that we literally talk about, and we bow down to the process, and we don't ever want to go back, which is why he started the term saying hardest workers in the room, which is what I really live by, and I stand by him when he says that, mm-hmm. because it says a lot about who he is and about who I am. We're not satisfied.
Yeah, and I think there is. There's a mutual respect that Kevin and I have, and you know, we have a lot of common friends in our business, and when we first got together for Central Intelligence, a movie we did 3-4 years ago, we thought we were going to have some pretty good chemistry, but then it really exploded into a really cool bond and brotherhood. There is a mutual admiration. Kevin has a lot of drive and ambition. You know, his mouth is like the Energizer Bunny, but that's okay. I just kind of looked by that. But I do have a tremendous amount of respect for this guy, and we always have a what?
You know, I was very positive the whole way through.
No, I know, but...
Yeah, but I didn't throw any shots.
That wasn't a shot.
But you waited for me to finish.
Energizer Bunny is actually a good thing.
That's why I don't like to go first.
You see, that's because I'm very smart. Yeah, you go first.
You see what I'm saying? You see what he did there, don't you? I'm not going to go first again.
Okay.
I bet you that. I'm not going first again while I'm sitting here.
I'm just saying, I have a lot of love and a lot of respect for you, and this is why, you know, it actually, you see it on screen when we get together.
Yeah.
And
also, I do a lot of the heavy lifting.
Okay.
That's
all right. Jumanji, welcome to the jungle is in theaters everywhere. December 20th.
He's carrying me on his back.